So to start with, there actually is a difference if you want to select a koi for right now or selecting a koi for the future. And personally, I tend to select koi by especially looking towards the future. I enjoy it when koi develop during the lifespan in the direction that I might have selected them for. So what are Oshiba Chiyura? If you translate it from Japanese, it means autumn leaves on the water. So the brown areas represent the leaves that fall off the trees. And of course, the gray areas are like the water, the atmosphere of the water during autumn and winter time as well. So these three Oshiba are bred by breeder Ofuchi. And why I think this variety is also nice to discuss in one of these videos is because it is not the most standard variety. It is something different than, for example, Gosanka. So the Oshiba came to existence by using the Chagoi and the Soragoi. So the Chagoi, that's why the Oshiba has the brown color. The Chagoi is basically, Cha means brown. So that's from the Chagoi. And the other part, the gray areas, are from the Soragoi. And Sora means like mouse gray. So brown and gray together, Chagoi and Soragoi together, and then, Oshiba Chiyura came to existence basically. And the typical characteristics of this variety is that it tends to be very, very tame. So it's really easy to let them eat out of your hands as well. So really nice koi to have in your pond. Fun fish as well. Well, enjoyable, nice fish. So in this video, I would like to cover a few topics. I will start the video by explaining like what aspects do we look for in the pattern of an Oshiba. And then I will talk about the face pattern as well. The colors, like the brown color, what do you look for? And the balance of the colors basically over the entire body of the fish, and also like the intensity of the brown color and what to look for. So, and at the end, I will also talk about which of these three Oshiba I would select, why I would select them, and like what are the differences in between the three Oshibas that I have in this bowl. Well, we basically have to pay attention to the pattern, of course. And usually we prefer to have like a multiple step pattern with multiple brown steps on the head, on the body, that makes an Oshiba, well, look nice basically. And it is actually quite easy because you can take the rules of selecting a Kohaku into account. So a Kohaku is a white fish with multiple red steps. Well, here the red is basically replaced with brown. So if you know what to look for when selecting a Kohaku, well, these are the basics to selecting a good Oshiba as well with a nice pattern. And personally, I always look for a pattern that looks really clean. So I like to have steps on the pattern. I also like it to be a little bit more playful, like this one. So what you see is like one step on the head, then smaller steps on the body, and it looks, well, quite playful. It has a good balance, smaller areas as well that are covered with brown. Well, it looks more playful than, for example, this one. This one is more like one big brown area. Some people like it. Well, personally, I don't think it's really, really that nice. But it is a personal taste, of course. What you want to look for is the sharpness of the edges. So the edges of the brown area. It should be as sharp as possible. And when we take a look at this Oshiba, you can see that the sharpness is not, well, it's basically not that sharp. On the head it is, but that's quite easy. But if you look here, there are small, yeah, like inconsistencies in the brown scales and areas here as well. Some small, well, like small dots of brown, and it should be a sharp edge. And when you look from above on an Oshiba, the brown patterns should stop in the middle of the lateral line of the fish. So if you look here, the brown basically stops halfway of the Oshiba. Maybe this is a good example. If I lift it, you can see the brown stops like just below the lateral line on both sides of the koi. Both sides. So that's one of the aspects I look for as well. If you look at this Ochiba, it has the same thing. Both sides. It stops at the lateral line. Let's see what this one does. Probably the same thing. Yes. At this side at least, and the other side as well. And for Ochiba, a good face pattern or head pattern makes or breaks the Ochiba. And I personally really like it if the pattern is playful. If, for example, like gray, if this side, for example, there was a gap with gray in it, it would be really, really cool and really playful. These all have more traditional patterns, like one step on the head. This one is a little bit better. The brown stops like just before the eyelid and at the other side as well, while this one, the brown lays over the eye. Even the eye is brown actually. And at the other side, well, it stops nearly there. That's better. And the other one has that as well. It stops just before the eye. Other side a little bit over the eye. It's still okay. But it should stop in between the eyes. That's the best what you have to look for. So if the brown lays in between the eyes, it is more clean. And it is also more appreciated by Japanese breeders and judges. So now we covered about the pattern and the face pattern. I would like to talk a bit about the brown patterns on the Ochiba. As the colors can be quite different, this Ochiba has a more darker brown color, and this Ochiba has a lighter color brown. It's lighter color brown. Well, I have to say it is still a little bit looking red oranges, but it is surely lighter red than this, or lighter brown than this Ochiba. Some of the Ochiba Chihure, just like the Chagoi, can almost look dark brown, chocolate brown. And I personally prefer it to be dark brown, because it usually tends to develop like a net pattern, a mesh pattern on the scales. So as you can see on this Ochiba, it has a net pattern, even on the gray ones and on the brown as well. Well, this one, well, it is surely also visible, but it is lighter. And it is more likely that on this Ochiba, the net pattern will really, will really develop more intense. Well, it's my personal opinion, but I prefer to have a net pattern on an Ochiba. It just looks really good. One thing you have to take into account when selecting Ochiba, and when we talk about the brown color, is that overall, like when these Ochibas go outside in the sun, in your pound, that all the brown will tend to become even more dark. And especially like late summer and early autumn, the brown is like at the darkest. So all the brown, also these lighter two ones, will become a little bit more dark. The brown color should be evenly divided over the body. So you want to make sure that when the brown, the intensity of the brown is like the same in this area as in the tail section area. The brown intensity should be the same over the entire body of the fish. Same as for Kohaku, where you want the red to be the same intensity over the entire body. Well, exactly the same for Ochiba Chihure, the brown should be of the same intensity. So there shouldn't be any differences. And when we take a look at this Ochiba, we can see that there actually are a little bit of differences. Because the brown on the shoulder area, so the brown on this shoulder area here, it is darker than at the side here. And also it's a different color of the beginning of the tail section, which is the tail section of this Ochiba, the brown is lighter. And you want it to be, well, basically the same intensity. And that is way better on this one. You can see that all the brown colors look the same. Looks exactly the same. So Well, it is an indication that the brown color is a little bit of better quality, I would like to say, than this one. Which Ochiba would I select if I have to make a decision between these three Ochibas? Well, of course, it is a little bit personal taste as well. But the first thing I would look for is the intensity of the brown color. So this one, in my opinion, has the best intensity of brown color. It is the darkest brown color as well. The second one is this one regarding intensity of the brown and darkness of the brown. And in the last place, this one. Because you can clearly see that this Ochiba, the dark brown color is inconsistent. It has, on some places, it is deeper brown than on other places. The second thing I would look for is the pattern. I like to have a playful pattern or nice steps. And again, this one is for me on the last place because it looks like one single pattern with like gray gaps in between, like a gap in the middle of the brown. And I don't like it. Japanese judges won't like it as well. Breeders don't really prefer to have it as well. So it should be a playful multiple step pattern. Well, preferable. For me, this one is the best when we talk about pattern aspects. Nice head pattern, well, a little bit over the eye on one side, but for me, it is still okay. I like the first step, it's playful. It's not like one big step. I like the different corners, basically. It looks more playful. And the last step. And the tail is, doesn't show a lot of brown, just a little bit on top here. For me personally, I would like to prefer if it was not there. Then this one, nice head pattern in between the eyes, so that's good. Small steps, tail section stops right before the tail, should have been a little bit more gray there as well. The only thing that is missing on this Ochiba is, there's something here and here missing. There's a little bit too much gray for my personal opinion. Should be a little bit more brown. So for me, for now, this one is regarding pattern, the best one, then this one, and this one on the last place. So then about the body shape, and I'm not going into detail here in the body shape, but this one shows the best body for now. Long head, long tail, high tail, a little bit broader tail as well. While this one, the body is a little bit smaller, it looks like. There is not a big difference, but the head is a little bit shorter. So I believe that this one will become larger. This one is also quite good body, but honestly, this is just not going to be my number one for sure. So I will just leave it there for now. So it is about this one and the other one. On both ones you can see the backbone visible, so an indication that the shoulder area can become more massive and grows larger. This is the backbone area. You can see like a small V-shape is visible on top of the shoulder. If we have to pick a number one, it's difficult. It is difficult for sure because I like this one more regarding red net pattern. I like this one more for the head pattern. I like this one more for this part. Yeah, for now I would select this one because I do believe that the net pattern will develop more. So the black will come become more intense. Brown is quite good quality. I like the playful pattern. So this is my number one. And the only reason for that is that this Ochiba is missing some brown. If it had more brown, I would definitely select this one because the brown is darker, there's a better net pattern, and I like the body, I like the head pattern. So this would be my number one, but some brown is missing. So therefore, this one for sure, and I believe that the net pattern will develop later on. And I also would like to know which one is your favorite. Is it going to be the same as my number one? This Ochiba Shigure with the more classic three-step pattern? Or is it going to be this one with the smaller brown darker brown patterns with the net pattern, or is it going to be this one that is like almost one big brown area with small gray gaps in between? Leave a comment. I'm really interested in knowing what you think of these three Ochibas. So if you like this video, leave a comment, put a thumbs up, and also consider to subscribe, because I will make sure that I regularly update you with new videos, new content about what happens in Japan, how breeders select their koi, what to look for when you select different varieties of koi, and of course I will show a lot more in the future. Thank you for watching again, and see you in the next video. Thank you.